Don't give away our address. I don't want people finding me.
Nobody knows where we are. We're in a cornfield.
That's true. All right. So we want to do our seat reviews? All right, so we're back from Sturgis.
No offense, backpack.
Back to the routine, trying to get some videos in. For weeks and months now, people have been asking for suspension review and seat reviews. I don't know if we're going to do a full suspension review tonight, but we're going to at least get the seat review done.
Suspension.
It's a suspension.
Don't slur.
I also wanted to update you. We are back in Connecticut, and I just want to let everybody know.
There's corn.
Corn. There's corn over there.
That's the tobacco.
Corn over there, see?
Yeah.
We're winging it. So, if you watched our earlier videos, both of us installed Lee Para seats. I guess I'll go first because I'm standing next to mine. I did the Lee Para tail whip. If you didn't watch the previous video, the only difference between this seat and the kick flip, which is the other step-up seat, is this has the little whip in the back there. And this is 14 inches wide in the pan instead of 12.
What's it have on the back?
Whip. Whip.
That's a cool whip.
So, I can say that the extra width is just perfect. Like, it's still a narrow seat where you can, it doesn't spread your legs out wide to stop. I'm not vertically challenging that, but it helps for, and it's still got that shortcut where it shows the side covers. Back support is great. I learned on my other seat in my highball that I like to step up seats. I'm 6 feet tall, so I'll show you. I got 12 inch bars on the bike. So it puts me into them right nicely, just like a little slack in my arms. I was told that the Lee Para is very much similar to stock seating position. They do sell the Daddy Long Legs version, which puts you 2 inches back, but that's, I would say, if you're super tall. Besides that, as I said, it's super great quality. All the stitching's held up. I probably have a few thousand miles on the seat. It was supposed to be a 1,000-mile review, but biggest ride I did on this, I did Laconia on it, which was probably 800 or 900 miles in 3 days. I have no complaints. I can say I probably could have run this seat to Sturgis, but I wasn't gonna put my wife on the back of this little thing for Sturgis, so we did run the stock touring seat. But she can vouch because she's filming right now for around town or dinner ride. I think you did like 150 on one day. We went to the shore. It's good for that, and that's where that whip actually makes a difference, because all the other ones they roll off flat, like right here, and it just slides your butt down into the backrest, right?
See.
You normally do get a backrest. I just took it off so you can have a clear shot of the seat. Fit and finish is great. It covers, if you come in here, camera woman, please. If you come in here, it covers most of the rub marks that the factory touring seat makes. So you can't see. Those blemishes are from my CB radio, and the bike's still just filthy from Sturgis. So yeah, I really like it. I think I'd buy a Lee Para seat again if I needed to. The only thing is, if you're one of those performance bagger guys and you're really trying to shave pounds, this might not be the seat for you. Quality-wise, it comes with a steel pan, which is an excellent fit, but this seat probably weighs 20 pounds, so you're adding weight to your bike. For me, it's an 800-pound bike. I'm not counting, but
it's all about quality.
The quality's there, so I'll let Graham talk about his. I'll let you talk. He did the whole Sturgis trip on his Lee Para seat.
So. Yep. I got probably, got the seat 3 months ago. Probably 8,000. It's probably 7,000 miles on it. This is the Lee Para Outcast. They make two Lee Para Outcasts. They make they call it the number two. Has more of a back seat. This is got a wide seat pan. More for if you're riding without a passenger, you know. But somebody could get ice cream on that, right? I mean, maybe. Love the seat so far. It's got, I ordered it with this. This was an extra $200, but the backrest. Fold down, get your leg over if you want. Fully adjustable. Awesome. It was a lifesaver for Sturgis because I got a bad back, you know, from working hard. And this was definitely awesome. I didn't use it the whole trip, but it was nice to be able to flip it backwards if you didn't want the back support in different positions while you're riding. Same as his. The fit and finish is great. It fits so tight. Haven't had a problem with it. The seat screw doesn't even loosen up. It's fully adjustable. everybody's butt gets sore on a motorcycle on a 5,000 mile trip. I mean, even if you had a big cushy seat, sitting down for that long still hurts, but I didn't have a problem with it. All in all, super happy with the seat. I think this is my fourth seat I've tried on the bike, and this is the one that's gonna stay forever. And really impressed with the pair. I tried a Mustang and two other Harley seats, and this is the girl. This isn't the daddy long legs or anything, just the regular one. But super happy with it. That's my 7,000 mile update. I said I was gonna do 6,000 miles ago.
We've been busy, we've been riding.
We've been busy, riding too much.
Making all the Sturgis videos. If this comes out before that, we're still working on them. A lot of editing. Yellowstone video will be out next, but that'll probably come out before this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thanks again for watching.
Yes, thanks for watching. Thanks for all the comments. Leave a comment. We've answered a lot of comments on the seats, but feel free to
leave a comment if you want to.
All right.
See you later.